Behind me, you can see the COVID testing facility that we've set up at Rensselaer to test students, faculty, and staff. We realized early on in March, when we were beginning to plan bringing the students back this fall, that in order to bring them back successfully, we were going to have a robust and efficient and effective testing system to keep everyone safe. Even though we knew a two-week quarantine was going to be a bit of a challenge for our students when they came back, it helped us make sure we were starting the semester without any cases here on campus.
We're very tight-knit in our floor. Being quarantined for 2 weeks really brought us closer together. We have actually been having little gatherings on our floor. So usually every weekend, everyone will be out in the common area at night. We've had movie nights, game nights. We had a virtual Smash Bros competition. We were playing Just Dance as well. And so we've kind of still found a way to bond and be together while also staying socially distant.
Undergraduate students come on either a Monday, Thursday, or Tuesday, Friday schedule, so they're all tested twice. We do about 7,000 tests in a week, maybe slightly more.
The testing has been pretty efficient in my experience. All I have to do is just leave campus just for a quick 30 minutes just to walk here and then take a quick test. It's really, really easy, really simple.
We come in, scan our ID, they get us in and out pretty quickly. They do the quick nose swab, do our testing vial, and then we're right out.
It's very well constructed. You schedule times to go and you're expected to make your appropriate time. If not, there's always substitutions that you can go to.
It makes me feel safe. They're being very adamant about all the rules surrounding getting tested.
The testing really gives me a reassurance. Like when I go into the dining hall, I'm not like nervous to take off my mask before I eat or anything. I just feel like we're in like a little safe bubble.
I think our ability to test so frequently, when we do get a positive, we're able to catch it right away, so prevent any of that from spreading throughout campus, so it's really keeping our numbers down.
The decision to test twice a week was based on an epidemiology modeling program that Professor Malik Magdon-Ismail developed in collaboration with a larger software modeling effort within IDEA, the Institute for Data, Exploration, and Applications here at Rensselaer.
So we put out a tool that's called COVID Back to School. We basically built a couple of models. These epidemiological models have something like an input. So how quickly does the virus spread? How long does a person get infected? These are sort of standard parameters for the COVID virus that by now we sort of know. The goal was to get this curve to stay under 1%. That was the high level goal. This is some of the capabilities that informed the decisions that were made by Dr. Lawrence, Dr. Cold, and ultimately by President Jackson. We know that this is necessary because several schools have had to close because they didn't do things like this.
With a combination of in-person and remote classes, a mandatory mask policy, and staggered dining arrangements, rigorous testing has helped us keep our positive numbers very low while educating thousands of students on campus. So far, we have performed more than 74,000 tests.
I have around three classes that are remote right now, fully remote instruction. I have one class that's in person, but the remote hasn't been too bad. I've been doing pretty well in my classes, and our teachers are always available if we have any questions or concerns.
People understand that there's a huge transition, so there's more faculty and staff to help you with the transition from in-person to online, and then from high school to college. There's mentoring for most of the classes, and if they don't have mentoring, there's ALAC or tutoring. Professors have a lot of good office hours, as well as TAs, and even just friends that are in the same class as you are very good with helping you and teaching you.
Most samples from the specimen collection facility are taken to the Rensselaer Testing Lab located at the Rensselaer Tech Park, which was set up by a research group led by Professor Jonathan Dordan.
We receive the clinical samples and basically 4 hours later we have the results because our lab has a very high throughput.
We have a robot, and this robot is actually helping us a lot to remove some of the human intervention, which is almost a source of variability.
We have two people at the time in the lab who basically just oversee the functioning of the robot and feed the robot the new coming samples. We can test simultaneously 1,000 samples per shift, 2,000 samples per workday.
COVID lab is run by volunteers. They are all scientists with PhDs from our PIs, and they agreed to give some of their time for the testing of the RPI community. And the rest of the community at RPI, all the departments, have been collaborating in a way that I think it's almost unheard of.
We developed quite a bit of IT infrastructure to to support testing and contact tracing. We developed web apps for daily wellness checks and for DIAL, the Daily Interaction and Activities Log, that aids in contact tracing. In addition, we automated the check-in process to make it go in about 20 seconds. And significantly, down at the tech park, we developed programs to automatically analyze the results that come out of the DNA testing machines.
We're immensely proud of what we've accomplished so far. We couldn't have done it without the cooperation of all of our students, especially our freshmen who've navigated this new normal with optimism and strength. And to all of them, I want to thank them.
Overall, we've still had such a great experience just being able to be here and meet people.
Honestly, I believe that the experience has been quite unique and interesting. Obviously, most of the class of 2020 has gone into their college freshman year thinking that it was probably going to be ruined due to COVID. But I honestly don't think that anything was ruined or damaged in any type of way. There's a lot of different things that we'd have to do versus how other freshmen have done it in the past. But I think it just helps us become stronger and more independent in the long run.